Fuerte ese aplauso a Jesús.
Come on, let me hear it loud for Jesus.
Aplauda con ritmo.
Come on, clap your hands like this.
Pero más fuerte.
Come on, do it louder.
Ahora, levanta los brazos.
Now, with your hands up.
Ahora, saltando.
Now, jump.
Aplaudiendo.
Clap your hands.
Más fuerte.
Come on, make it louder.
Levantando los brazos.
With your hands up.
Y saltando.
And jump.
Todo el mundo saltando.
Everybody jump.
Con el brazo derecho.
With your right hand.
Ahora con el izquierdo.
Now with your left hand.
Aplaudiendo.
And clap your hands.
Ahora voy a aplaudir al ritmo mío.
Now you're gonna clap at my pace. Now point towards the heavens
y declara,
and declare,
mi socorro,
my help,
viene de lo alto,
comes from above,
del Señor,
from the Lord,
que hizo los cielos,
who made heaven
y la tierra,
and earth.
Ahora, van a girar,
now you're going to spin around,
y cuando estén girando,
and as you're spinning,
van a sentir que Dios pone un cerco de protección,
you're going to feel God placing a fence of protection
de su vida,
around your life,
de su familia,
around your family,
de su ministerio,
around your ministry,
y de sus finanzas,
and around your finances.
Todo girando.
Come on!
Ahora, cambio de mano.
Now with your other hand.
Aplaudiendo.
Come on, clap your hands, everybody.
Aplauda con fuerza.
Do it, come on, loud.
Ahora, levanta el brazo derecho.
Now, lift your right hand up.
Baja la mano, así.
And put your hand down like this.
Baja a la izquierda.
Your left hand down.
Ahora va a cambiar de posición.
Now you're going to switch positions.
Pero danzando.
But you're going to dance.
Y nadie se va a quedar.
And nobody's going to remain still.
Todo el mundo va a danzar.
Everybody's going to dance.
¿Listos?
Are you ready?
Dance así.
You're going to dance like this. Now tell the person next to you.
Nacerás al ministerio en esta convención.
You will be born to the ministry in this conference.
Pueden tomar sus asientos.
You may be seated.
¿Cuántos quieren aprender de la palabra?
Now, how many of you want to learn from the Word of God?
Hay un pasaje que está en el libro de Mateo.
There's a scripture found in the book of Matthew.
En el capítulo 6, en el verso 10.
In chapter 6, in verse 10.
Y dice,
it says,
venga tu reino.
Your kingdom come.
Hágase tu voluntad.
Your will be done.
Como en el cielo,
on earth,
así también en la tierra.
As it is in heaven.
Diga conmigo.
Say with me.
Señor Jesús.
Lord Jesus.
Habla mi vida.
Speak to my life.
Ministra mi corazón.
Minister to my heart.
Que hoy tu palabra,
Lord, I pray that your word,
me sea revelada,
will be revealed to me,
para que yo la entienda,
that I could understand it,
la guarde,
meditate upon
la declare,
it, declare it,
y la practique,
and put it to practice.
Te lo pido,
Lord,
en el nombre
I pray
de Jesús,
that you do this in the amen. Name of Jesus. Amen.
Y amen.
Amen.
Conociendo el reino de Dios,
getting to know the kingdom of God.
A veces nos cuesta tanto entender.
A lot of times it's so hard for us to understand.
¿Cuál es el propósito del reino divino?
What is the purpose of God's kingdom?
Cuando Dios creó la primera pareja,
when God made the first couple,
él mismo dijo,
he himself said,
hagamos al hombre,
let us make man,
a nuestra imagen y semejanza,
according to our image and likeness,
para que él señoreara sobre todo,
that man could rule over all things.
Es interesante.
Now it's very interesting.
Que del verso 26 del capítulo primero de Génesis,
that from Genesis 1 and verse 26
al verso 27,
when we move on to verse 27,
hay un cambio sustancial.
There is a major shift, a major change.
El verso 26,
because you see in verse 26,
dice, hagamos al hombre,
it says, let us make man,
a nuestra imagen y semejanza,
in our image according to our likeness.
La imagen representa la parte externa.
So image represents the outer part.
La semejanza la parte interna.
And likeness refers to the inward part.
Dios al pensar crear al hombre,
so when God thought of creating man,
quiso que tuviera las mismas características de él.
He wanted man to have the same characteristics as he had.
Y por eso pensó en imagen.
And that's why he thought about image and likeness.
Pero si lee el verso 27,
but if you look at verse 27,
va a notar el cambio.
You're going to notice there's a change.
E hizo Dios al hombre.
It says, so God created man
a su imagen,
in his own image.
A imagen de Dios lo hizo,
in the image of God, he created him.
Varón y hembra.
Male and female, he created them.
Note que omitió la parte de semejanza.
If you notice, in verse 27, it doesn't mention the part of likeness.
¿Por qué omitió la parte de semejanza?
Why is the part of likeness not mentioned in verse 27?
Porque la semejanza habla del carácter interno.
Because the likeness of God, it has to do with our inward character.
Y para que adquiriese la semejanza de Dios,
and for us to have the likeness of God,
debería ser obediente.
Man need to be obedient to God.
Razón por la cual los puso en el huerto.
And that's the reason why he placed man in the garden.
Y les mostró todos los frutos del huerto.
And he showed them all the fruit that was in the garden.
Les dijo, de todos los frutos del huerto y de todos los árboles podréis comer.
And he said to the first couple, you may eat of the fruit that is in the garden, of all the fruit that's in the garden.
Todos sabemos que habían dos árboles que hacían la diferencia.
Now we know that there are two trees that made the difference in the garden.
El árbol de la vida.
There was the tree of life.
Y el árbol del conocimiento de lo bueno.
And then the tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
Ahora, detrás del árbol de la vida,
now,
o en el árbol de la vida,
now on the tree of life,
está el Espíritu Santo.
The Holy Spirit is there.
Detrás de, del árbol del conocimiento,
and behind the tree of knowledge of good and evil,
está la serpiente.
There was the serpent.
Y Dios puso la prueba de fuego.
And so God set a test in place.
La obediencia.
He wanted to test man's obedience.
¿Cuántos creyentes hay que aman a Dios con todo
el
corazón?
Because you see, there are many believers that love God with all of their heart.
Pero no le obedecen en todo.
But they're not fully obedient to God.
Le obedecen de acuerdo a circunstancias.
They just seem to obey them according to the circumstances.
Y a Dios hay que obedecerle en
todo. But you see, God, we must obey him in all things.
Y algunos no entienden lo que es la obediencia.
Some people don't understand what obedience is.
Que él pide obediencia inmediata.
Because God demands instant obedience, immediate obedience.
Nuestro destino depende de esas obediencias.
You see, our destiny depends on our obedience.
¿Cuántas jovencitas?
There are so many young ladies
se entusiasman con un joven.
That fall in love with a certain guy.
Oran, ayunan,
and they pray and they fast and they intercede.
Y cuando Dios les dice que no.
And when God says no.
Ahí cambia de actitud.
Then their attitude changes.
Ahí se olvidan de obedecer.
And they forget about obedience.
Obediencia es en todo.
Obedience is in all things.
A veces Dios dice sí, a veces dice no.
A lot of times God says yes, sometimes he says no.
¿Cuántas personas han batallado?
But so many people have battled.
Entre la empresa y el ministerio.
They've had battles like, what do? Ministry or do I do business?
Y cuando Dios les dice, te quiero en el ministerio.
And when God says to them, I want you in the ministry.
Pero yo gano muy poco.
They're like, but I'm going to make very little money if I'm in the ministry.
En la empresa puedo hacer dinero.
But if I'm in business,
puedo ayudar en la obra.
I can make money and I could help the work of God.
Y desobedece.
So they choose to disobey God.
¿Cuántos están en un cargo importante?
Or there are people that are in an important position.
Y Dios les dice, ya no lo necesito ahí.
And God says to you, I don't need you in that position anymore.
Los necesito en mi obra.
I need you working for my kingdom.
Años atrás.
Some years ago.
8 años atrás.
I would say about 8 years ago.
Estábamos en la convención en Bogotá.
We had our conference in Bogotá. It was going on.
Mi esposa estaba como candidata para el Senado.
And my wife was a senator for candidate for Senate.
Uno de los conferencistas invitados fue el reverendo John Hagee.
And one of our guest speakers was Reverend John Hagee.
Y cuando pasamos juntamente con mi esposa para saludarlo.
And so when my wife and I approached him to greet him,
a él le cae la unción profética.
He received this prophetic anointing.
Y empieza a darle una palabra profética
a mi esposa. And he starts speaking to my wife prophetically.
Y le dice la palabra profética, y el Señor te ha dado una palabra de autoridad.
The Lord has given you a word of authority for your government.
Y harás en un día lo que muchos pastores hacen en un año.
And in a single day you will be able to do what it takes most pastors an entire year to do.
Después de ese tiempo de compartir.
So after that time of fellowship with him,
íbamos para la casa.
We were on our way back home.
Y mi esposa me dice.
And my wife said to me.
¿En sí qué fue lo que quiso decir el Señor con esa palabra?
She asked me, what did the Lord mean through the prophetic word that John Hagee gave me?
Y le dije, no sé.
And I said, well, I'm not sure.
Vamos a orar.
But we're going to pray about it.
Al día siguiente, cuando
the next day,
voy a mi tiempo de oración,
as I was going to have my time of prayer,
le dije, Señor,
I said, Lord,
¿qué quisiste decirle a Claudia con esta palabra profética?
What did you want to say to Claudia through that prophetic word?
¿Con esto la quieres afirmar?
Does it mean that you really want her
en el Senado o en el
running
ministerio?
For Senate, or do you want her to be in the ministry?
Y me dice el Señor.
And the Lord spoke to me.
Si la quisiera en el Senado,
he said, if I had wanted her to be a senator,
le diría,
I would have said,
harás en un día lo que muchos pastores hacen, y muchos senadores hacen en un año.
In one day you will be able to do what it takes senators to do in an entire year.
Pero como la quiero en el ministerio,
but because I want her in the ministry,
le dijo el Señor,
the Lord said,
harás en un día,
you will be able to do in one day what it takes many pastors
harán en un año
to do in an entire year.
Cuando
when
mi esposa se despertó,
my wife woke up,
le llevo el cafecito,
I brought coffee up to her as usual,
y le digo, ya tengo la respuesta.
And I said, honey, I have an answer from God.
Y me dice, ¿cuál es?
And she said, what is it?
El Señor te quiere en el ministerio.
I said, the Lord wants you in the ministry.
Estamos a 2 meses de elección.
We were 2 months away from the day of the election.
Y me dice ella,
and she said to me,
¿y cuál la respuesta?
And so what's the answer?
Cuando le comparto la respuesta,
when I shared the answer with her,
mi esposa quedó en shock.
My wife, she was shocked. She was like stunned.
No esperaba eso.
She wasn't expecting that answer.
Lo procesó.
She thought about it for a moment.
Por dos minutos.
Just like 2 minutes.
Porque ella es obediencia inmediata.
She likes to instantly obey God.
Iba, mis hijas estaban desayunando.
Our daughters were having breakfast.
Y les dice, hijas.
And she walked up to them. She said, girls.
Ya no voy a ser senadora.
I'm not going to run for senate anymore.
Voy a ser pastor.
I'm going to be a pastor.
Mis hijas ni entendían.
And my daughters couldn't even understand why she was saying that.
Pero mi esposa sabía.
But my wife knew.
Lo que estaba haciendo.
What she was doing.
Hace 4 años.
4 years ago.
Mi esposa me dice.
My wife said to me.
¿Será que en esta ocasión puedo?
She said, should I run this time?
Le dije, no siento.
And I said, I don't think you should.
Tampoco corrió.
And so she didn't run.
Para esta ocasión.
Now this time we had an election recently.
Ella no.
So.
Se había inscrito para
she
correr.
She wasn't even thinking of signing up to run for Senate.
Y.
And.
Me dice, mi amor, ¿y qué hacemos?
She said, honey, what do we do?
Le dije, este es el tiempo.
I said, this is the time.
Tú vas a correr.
I said, you're going to run.
Y ella me miró.
And she looked at me.
Y me dice, ahora.
She said, now?
Le dije, sí.
I said, yes.
Su rostro brilló.
Her face, she was just sparkling.
Bueno, y gracias a Dios pudo ganar.
And thank God she made it. She was elected.
Porque fue una batalla fuerte.
Because it was a very tough battle.
Se posesionó hace poco.
She was just sworn in a few weeks ago.
Quería estar en la comisión primera que trabaja con todo lo que tiene que ver con la Constitución
de la Nación. Senator, there are 7 commissions. She wanted to be in Commission 1, which is for any matter regarding our Constitution.
Pero las cosas no se dieron y quedó en la comisión segunda.
Didn't work out for her to be part of the first commission, so she was appointed to the second commission.
Que tienen que ver con todo lo internacional.
Which is the area regarding anything that's regarding international relations.
El presidente
turns out
pasado,
that our former president who just came out of office
terminó su mandato el 7 de agosto.
His mandate finished on August 7th.
Y antes de que se posesionara el nuevo presidente.
And his final act as the official president before the new president was sworn in.
Sacó un artículo.
He made a decision.
Que reconocía a Palestina como
where he was recognizing Palestine as a state.
Nadie en Colombia tenía
idea. In Colombia, no one had an idea that he had plans to do that.
Fue una sorpresa para toda la
nación. It took the whole nation by surprise.
Porque siempre las relaciones habían sido
because
con Israel,
we've
no con
always
Palestina.
Had a very strong relationship with Israel, not with Palestine.
Y como mi esposa está en la comisión segunda.
And because she ended up in the second commission,
desde ahí le toca dar la batalla para ver cómo se desmonta eso.
She understood that God brought her there to fight the battle to reverse the plan that the former president set in motion.
Nada es por casualidad.
So nothing happens by chance.
Dios sabe cuándo lo necesita.
God knows when he needs you and why he needs you.
Ahora,
now,
en Mateo 6,
in Matthew 6,
habla de que venga tu reino.
It says, your kingdom come.
Eso fue lo que el Señor dijo.
And that's what the Lord said.
La primera pareja fue puesta en el huerto del Edén.
So the first couple, Adam and Eve, they were placed in the Garden of Eden.
Tenían la imagen de Dios.
And they had the image of God.
Pero la semejanza.
But the likeness of God.
Dependía de eso tan pequeño que se llama obediencia.
It depended on a very small matter called obedience.
Si usted mira,
if you look at it,
lo más difícil para un discípulo es obedecer.
The most difficult part for a disciple is in the area of obedience.
Me ha tocado formar muchos discípulos.
I have formed so many disciples throughout the years.
Pero desde hace muchos años atrás me di cuenta cuál era el discípulo correcto y cuál no.
Many years ago I learned to find who were obedient and good disciples and who were not.
Cuando yo daba un desafío,
and whenever I present a challenge to the team,
siempre había uno
there was always a guy that would always raise his hand.
Y decía, no, pastor, eso que usted habla
and
está muy bien.
He would always say, pastor, what you're saying is great.
Pero en ese punto,
but you know,
no estoy de acuerdo.
There's this point of something that you mentioned that I don't agree with.
Al principio yo pensaba que eso era democracia.
And at first I thought it was a democracy.
Luego me di cuenta que era rebelión.
And then I realized it was a rebellion.
Que con el paso del tiempo,
because as time passed,
ese discípulo fue el que más problemas me
disciple
causó.
Is the one that caused me the most problems in my ministry.
Por su espíritu de rebelión.
Because of his spirit of rebellion.
Algunos les cuesta el trabajo.
It's so hard for some obedecer. People to
obedecer.
It's so hard for some people to learn to obey.
Y el Señor qué pedía?
And what was the Lord asking for?
De lo que él había formado.
He was asking of something of the people that he had made.
Obediencia.
He just wanted them to be obedient to him.
¿Cuántas personas están de acuerdo con lo que dice la Biblia? Pero
so many
dice,
people,
Señor, en esto sí no estoy de acuerdo.
They say they agree with the Bible, but all of a sudden they say, Lord, I don't really agree with this part of the Bible.
La Biblia es para obedecer.
The Bible was made for us to obey it.
Lógico.
Of course.
No somos judaizantes.
We are not in Judaism.
Nos guiamos por lo que enseña el Nuevo Testamento.
But we are moved by what the New Testament teaches us.
Pero el Señor fue muy claro en los principios
but
que quedaron plasmados en el Nuevo Testamento.
Was very clear in the principles that are found in the New Testament.
Y él pide es obediencia total.
And he requires absolute obedience on our behalf.
Ahora,
now,
cuando la pareja se encontró en el huerto.
When the first couple, when they were in the garden.
Ahí están en el huerto.
There they were standing in the garden.
Yo creo que Adán,
and I think Adam,
se quedó mirando el árbol de la vida.
Was probably looking at the tree of life.
Y le dijo a Eva,
and he said to his wife Eve,
acerquémonos.
He said, let's just go and see it.
Para probar algo del fruto.
Let's just try some of the fruit.
Pero ese momento,
but in that moment,
Eva no le está prestando mucha atención porque está mirando el otro árbol.
Eve was not paying much attention to him because she was looking at the other tree.
Y le dice Adán.
And so she said, Adam.
Es que yo tengo una curiosidad.
I'm just a bit curious.
Ese es un don innato.
You know, that's a natural gift for women to be curious.
La curiosidad.
Curiosity.
Y dice, yo tengo una curiosidad.
And she said, I'm just a little curious.
¿Por qué el Señor?
Why did the Lord?
No quiere que.
Why?
Probemos ese fruto.
Doesn't he want us to try the fruit from that?
Solo por curiosidad.
I mean, I'm just curious.
Acerquémonos.
Let's
a ver.
Just go and have a look.
¿Qué es lo que tiene de mal?
I just want to see what's so wrong about that tree, about the fruit of that tree.
Ahora,
now,
Adán era un hombre sabio.
Adam was a man with great wisdom.
Él sabía.
Because he knew.
Que llevarle la contraria a la mujer era un problema.
That you can't go against what your wife says, that's a big problem.
Estábamos en una convención en Miami. En
we were at one of our conferences in Mexico.
Estábamos una cena.
And so we're having dinner.
Habían cientos de pastores.
There were hundreds of pastors in that dinner.
Estábamos en la mesa principal.
And so we're sitting in the main table.
Y uno de los pastores anfitriones.
One of the pastors who was hosting that dinner.
Me dice, ¿le puedo hacer una pregunta?
He said, pastor, let me ask you something.
Le dije, claro.
I said, yeah, sure. What is it?
Me dice, he said, ¿cuánto usted pelea con su esposa?
Pastor, how often do you fight with your wife?
Y le dije, no,
I said, oh, we never fight. He was like, whoa.
Se sorprendió.
He was so surprised.
Y me dice,
and then he said,
si no es porque usted es mi pastor,
I mean,
no le creería.
I know you're my pastor, so I have to believe you.
Pero,
but,
¿cómo le hace para no pelear con su mujer?
How is it that you never fight with your wife?
Le dije,
I said,
no conozco el primero.
Well, I have never met a man
que le haya ganado una discusión a su mujer y le haya ido bien.
Who wins the discussions at home when he fights with his wife and does well in life?
Le dije,
I said,
no se da cuenta
don't
que ella no se equivoca.
Don't you realize that women never make mistakes?
Y el pastor abre los ojos
and he
así.
Opened his eyes so big.
Y me dice, pastor.
And he said, pastor.
Ella sí se equivoca.
That's not true. They do make mistakes.
y se equivocan mucho.
And actually they make a lot of mistakes.
Y le dije, bueno,
and I said, well,
es usted y yo lo
that's sabe. Something that you and
no,
I know,
que no.
But hey, let's just get them to think they never make mistakes.
Imagínese la mujer mirando el fruto.
Imagine Eve looking at the fruit.
Le dice a Adán, acerquemos.
And she says, Adam, let's go and have a look.
Y se acerca.
And so they went and had a look.
Y ahí muerden el anzuelo.
And they bit the enemy's bait.
Los que han podido ir a Israel notarán.
If you've ever visited Israel, you will notice
que del lugar de Palestina.
You might have noticed that the Palestine area
y de Jerusalén.
And then Jerusalem.
Hay una sola
there's
calle.
Just basically a street that separates them.
Y cuando uno sale de un lugar,
and when you walk out of one place and move on to the other place,
nota inmediatamente el cambio de la atmósfera.
You immediately notice a major change in the atmosphere.
¿Qué es lo que hace la atmósfera?
So what makes an atmosphere?
Nos habla de espíritus territoriales.
An atmosphere is filled with territorial spirits.
Donde predomina el mal, la atmósfera del mal.
Wherever evil has dominion, there's a bad atmosphere.
Donde predomina el bien, la atmósfera del bien.
Where
reina.
Goodness is reigning, then there's a good atmosphere in that place.
Y cuando el Señor le dijo a la pareja,
and when the Lord said to the first couple,
que no comieran de ese fruto,
to not eat from the fruit of that tree,
no estaba bromeando con ellos.
He wasn't kidding with them.
No estaba hablando de una posibilidad.
He wasn't speaking of something bad that might happen.
No les estaba dando una simple advertencia.
He wasn't giving them some little warning.
Les estaba dando una orden.
He was actually giving them an order.
Que de eso dependería el destino de ellos.
And their destiny depended on their obedience to that mandate.
El día que coman de él,
he said,
morirán.
For the day you eat the fruit thereof, you will verily die.
Pero cuando pisan el territorio,
but when they stepped into the enemy's camp,
ya quedaron bajo la nube del encantamiento.
They stepped under a cloud of enchantment.
Ganarle una discusión,
when you try to
al adversario,
the enemy in a discussion,
es muy difícil.
In a debate, it's very difficult.
Porque él es maestro en
engaño.
Because
he is a master at deceit.
Es el padre de la mentira.
He is the father of all lies.
Él sabe cómo envolver a la gente.
He knows how to entice people.
Con su astucia. Y su
he's very swift in the way he does it.
La mujer,
so the woman,
se encontró envuelta.
She found herself enticed by that atmosphere.
¿Y la trajo en qué?
And how did it, how was she drawn?
En que empezó a mirar el fruto.
In that she started looking at the fruit.
La vista.
Her sight.
Luego,
then,
empezó a codiciar el fruto.
She started coveting the fruit.
Y luego,
and then,
quiso tomar el fruto.
She wanted to take the fruit.
Lo que habla Santiago.
So it's what we find in the book of James.
Todo empieza con un deseo.
It all begins with a desire.
Y esto va creciendo.
And that desire begins to grow.
Hasta convertirse en una pasión,
until
y esto conlleva el pecado.
It becomes a passion that leads people into sin.
El diablo no cambia de estrategia.
The devil never changes his strategy.
Y así fue como
and
el enemigo logró
is how the enemy was able
atrapar a la primera pareja.
To trap the first couple.
Cuando Dios los creó,
when God created us,
nos hizo seres tripartitos.
He made us three-parted beings.
Espíritu, alma y cuerpo.
Spirit, soul, and body.
El cuerpo,
so
cinco sentidos.
The body has five senses.
El alma,
the soul,
mente, emociones y voluntad.
Has mind, emotions, and will.
Y el espíritu,
and the spirit,
es esa parte,
is that part,
que podríamos decir es exclusiva de Dios.
That we could say it belongs exclusively to God.
Esa parte es la que nos puede dar la semejanza.
And that is the part that could give us the likeness of God.
Pero que está, como lo dije antes, sujeto a la obediencia.
But like I said, it is subject to our obedience to God.
Cuando
when
la primera pareja peca,
when the first couple sinned,
el espíritu murió.
The spirit died.
Quedó activa el alma y el cuerpo.
So the soul and the body remained active.
Eso fue como si el alma se hubiese unido con el cuerpo.
It was as if the soul had been united to the body.
Para darle un golpe de estado al espíritu.
To perform a coup d'état on the spirit.
Y por esta razón,
and for that reason,
es que el enemigo se siente dueño de toda la tierra.
The enemy feels that he's the owner of all the earth.
Porque el hombre quedó solo como alma viviente.
Because the man remained only as a living being.
¿Qué es lo que enseña 1 Corintios capítulo 15 verso 45?
What we find in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 45.
Que dice fue hecho el primer hombre alma viviente.
It says that the first man Adam was made a living being.
El postrer.
And then the Adam. Last Adam
Espíritu vivificante.
It says that he was a life-giving spirit.
Note que ahí Pablo
notice that Paul
menciona de que el hombre
was saying that man
vino a ser alma viviente,
became a living being.
No menciona nada del espíritu,
but it doesn't mention the spirit at all,
porque el espíritu murió por causa del
pecado.
Because
the spirit died because of sin.
Pero de Jesús,
but when he talks of Jesus,
no menciona el alma.
He doesn't mention the soul.
Dice fue hecho el
he says
Adán.
The last Adam was made,
Jesús.
Referring to Jesus,
Espíritu,
and he said a life-giving spirit.
Ahora,
now,
miremos la otra cara de la moneda.
Let's look at the other side of the coin.
Jesús.
Jesus.
Jesús se encontró
Jesus found
en las mismas condiciones que Adán.
He found the same conditions as Adam found here on earth.
Nació sin el pecado original.
He was born without the original sin.
El Espíritu Santo vino sobre la Virgen María.
The Holy Spirit came upon Virgin Mary.
Concibió ella en su vientre.
And she conceived in her womb.
Nació Jesús.
And Jesus was born
como la última oportunidad de Dios.
And he was born as God's last opportunity for mankind.
Y la vida de Jesús.
And the life of Jesus
tuvo un transcurrir muy normal.
His life seemed to be very normal, apparently.
Desde su nacimiento,
ever since the moment of his birth on earth, all the way to the time of his baptism,
una obra sobrenatural.
Nothing supernatural was performed by Jesus.
Su vida era tan normal
como cualquier persona. His life was so normal like any other person's life.
Tanto que ni siquiera los mismos hermanos de Jesús creían en él.
So much so that his own brothers and sisters didn't believe in him.
Tuvo ese nacimiento.
So he had that kind of birth.
Tal vez tuvo las mismas condiciones.
And perhaps he experienced the same things.
No comerás de ese fruto.
You shall not eat the fruit thereof.
El mismo mandato de Adán lo tenía.
Basically, the same mandate that Adam received, Jesus received it too.
Ahora, cuando Jesús va donde Juan el Bautista,
when Jesus went to John the Baptist,
a que lo bautice,
to be baptized by John the Baptist,
Juan el Bautista,
John the Baptist,
ya había recibido la revelación que Jesús era el Cordero de
Dios. He had already received revelation that Jesus was the Lamb of God.
Y cuando ve que Jesús
and when
quiere,
he saw that Jesus was coming to him,
dice, vengo a que me bautice.
He said, I've come to be baptized by you.
Juan se espantó.
John was shaken.
Porque él sabía
because
que Jesús no tenía ningún
he
pecado.
Knew that there was no sin in Jesus.
Y le dice, Señor,
and he said, Lord,
yo soy el que
necesita I am the one who needs to be baptized by you.
Tú vienes
but
a ti.
Yet you come to me.
Y el Señor le dice,
and the Lord answered him.
Deja, Juan.
He said, Lord, John, let it be.
Porque así conviene que cumplamos
for
toda justicia.
It is necessary for us to fulfill all righteousness.
Juan,
John,
lo sumergió en el Jordán.
Immersed him in the waters of the Jordan.
Recuerde.
Now remember
que la inmersión,
that immersion
representa sepultamiento.
Represents a burial.
Es lo que dice Pablo en Romanos.
That's what
6,
Paul
10.
Tells us in Romans chapter 6 and verse 6.
Uno se sumerge.
So you're immersed.
Es como si bajara la tumba.
And it's as if you were going down to your tomb.
Y sale.
And then you come out. It's as if you were resurrecting.
Y Jesús, en un acto de
and
fe,
Jesus, in an act of faith,
bajó a las aguas.
He went down into the waters.
Lo hizo por obediencia,
but he did it out of obedience.
Dando ejemplo a todos.
He was setting an example for everyone.
Para que nadie vaya a decir, yo no necesito de
so
mí.
That none would say, I don't need baptism.
Si Jesús lo practicó,
if
¿por qué
Jesus
no nosotros?
Experienced baptism, why shouldn't we?
Pero cuando sale del agua,
but when he came up out of the water,
¿qué ocurrió?
What happened?
Los cielos se abrieron.
The heavens opened.
El Espíritu Santo descendió.
And the Spirit descended
en forma
in
corporal como
the form of a dove.
Y permaneció sobre él.
And it remained upon him.
Y vino una voz del cielo.
And then a voice from heaven was heard that said,
es mi
this
hijo amado,
is my beloved Son,
en el cual
in whom I am well pleased.
Nunca antes de eso,
never before that,
Jesús se atrevió a expulsar el demonio de nadie.
Had Jesus dared to cast a demon out of anyone?
Nunca quiso hacer nada sobrenatural.
He had not even tried to do anything supernatural.
Obró con toda la sabiduría.
He waited and he used wisdom.
Aunque era el verbo de Dios,
though he was the verb of God himself,
no se iba a enfrentar solo a un enemigo como el diablo.
He decided not to stand alone versus an enemy like the devil.
Él necesitaba la ayuda del Espíritu.
Because he knew that he needed the help of the Holy Spirit.
Cuando llegó el Espíritu Santo,
and when the Holy Spirit came upon him,
lo primero que hace,
the very first thing he did,
el Espíritu mismo lo impulsa,
the Spirit led him
al desierto,
to the wilderness,
para ayunar,
to fast,
para enfrentar al diablo,
and to go and face the devil.
Los dos estaban ansiosos de enfrentar al diablo.
So he was ready to face, anxious to face the devil.
Pero solo hasta que vino el Espíritu Santo.
But only when the Holy Spirit came upon him.
Como diciéndole,
that
Lord,
like saying, the time has come
tentador,
to go and face the tempter.
Cosa que no hizo la primera pareja.
That's something that the first couple didn't do.
Fueron todos solos.
They did everything on their own. They were not on
sin
guard.
El respaldo del Espíritu Santo.
They did not have the backing of the Holy Spirit on them.
Y les fue muy mal.
And it didn't go well for them.
¿Cuántas veces?
So many times.
El ser humano se encuentra expuesto a hacer lo mismo.
Human beings expose themselves to doing the same thing as the first couple.
Nunca de un paso.
Don't you ever take a step
sin tener respaldo,
without having 100% backing of the Holy Spirit.
Nunca.
Never do that.
Sin él no podemos hacer nada.
Without him we can't do anything.
El Espíritu Santo tiene que ser el todo en nuestras
vidas. The Holy Spirit has to be everything in our lives.
Catherine Kuhlman aprendió a decir,
she learned to say,
Dios mío,
Lord,
usa mi nada.
Use the nothing in me.
Ella aprendió a depender.
She learned to depend on the Holy Spirit and realized she was nothing, he was everything.
Y no fue una tarea fácil.
And that wasn't an easy task for her.
Lo tuvo que aprender con los golpes de la vida.
She had to learn it through many difficulties that she went through in life.
De un hombre casado.
You see, she fell in love with a man who was married.
Aunque él se divorció, ella se casó con él.
And though he divorced and then she married him.
Pero Dios no aprobó eso.
But God didn't approve of that relationship.
Se apartó del ministerio de
she
él.
Was basically completely
no
separated from the ministry and the miracle stopped happening.
Todo cambió.
It all changed for her.
Y cuando ella va a la oración, Señor,
and when she
pasando?
Went back to prayer, Lord, what is happening?
El Señor le dice,
the Lord said,
tú sabes que está,
you know what is happening.
Me cambiaste a mí,
you
ese hombre.
Traded me for that man.
Ahí ella entendió.
And then she understood.
Lo amo. Pero amo más al Espíritu Santo.
I love this man, but I love the Holy Spirit more than I love this man.
Y ahí fue cuando rompió esa relación.
And that's when she broke up from that relationship.
Se arrepintió.
She repented.
Consagró su vida a Dios.
She reconsecrated her life to God.
Y Dios la restauró.
And God restored her.
Y por eso la hizo esa tremenda.
And that's why she was such a mighty woman of God.
Que dejó una huella.
She left a mark
en la humanidad.
That cannot be erased in the life of mankind.
Todo es por obediencia.
It all happens because of obedience.
Ahora,
now,
¿cuántos de nosotros,
so many of us,
jugamos con la salvación?
We play around with salvation.
Pensamos que
we think
la santidad
that holiness
es para cierto día de la semana,
is for a certain day of the week,
y no nos damos cuenta,
and we don't realize
es todo el tiempo,
that it's all the time.
No podemos decirle al Espíritu Santo,
we can't say to the Holy Spirit,
vuelve el próximo domingo en la mañana,
come back next Sunday morning,
déjame hacer lo que yo quiera con mi vida,
because I'm going to do what I want with my life.
El Espíritu Santo no es alguien que
the Holy Spirit
tomamos,
is not someone we take or leave and take and leave and take and leave.
O lo tomamos,
either we take
o lo
him
tomamos,
or we don't take him.
No hay término medio.
There is no middle ground.
Cuando uno se entrega,
when you surrender,
Dios no pide un pedazo de su vida.
God doesn't ask for a little piece of your life.
Él no pide
he doesn't
80%.
Ask for 80% of your life.
Ni un 90%.
He doesn't even ask for 90% of your life.
Ni un 99%.
And not even 99% of your life.
O le da todo,
either
no
you
da
give him everything or don't even give him anything.
Pero ¿por qué él es tan exigente?
But why is he so demanding?
Porque él lo dio todo.
Because he gave it all for you.
Si él lo dio todo,
if he gave it all,
él lo pide un pedazo,
then he doesn't just demand a piece of your life.
Él pide todo.
He demands for everything in your life.
O nos rendimos totalmente.
Either we fully surrender to him, or we don't surrender at all.
Pero tiene que ser una entrega total.
But we have to absolutely surrender.
El Señor Jesús lo dio todo.
Jesus gave it all.
Cuando fue impulsado por el Espíritu al
when
desierto,
he was led by the Spirit into the wilderness,
después de esos 40 días de ayuno,
after those 40 days of fasting,
ya sabían que iba a llegar el tentador.
They knew that the tempter was coming.
Porque desde el mismo momento el Espíritu Santo,
because from the very first moment
that the ayunara,
Holy Spirit led him to fast,
y para que fuera tentado,
and to be tempted.
No sé si han vivido esos momentos.
Now, I don't know if you've ever gone through those moments
en que tienen que enfrentar la tentación.
Where you know you're going to have to face temptation.
Yo lo he vivido.
I've experienced those moments.
Recuerdo que cuando
I remember
mi hija Johanna estaba pequeña, Lorena también pequeña.
When my daughter Johanna and Lorena, when they were very little,
teníamos un evento fuera de la ciudad.
We had an event.
Ah, no, no un evento, era un tiempo de descanso con la familia fuera de la ciudad.
We had a little holiday, family holiday in the outskirts of our city.
Media,
about 2 hours away from our city.
Y tuve que regresar el sábado.
And so I needed to come back on Saturday night so I could preach on Sunday and then go back.
Pero
however,
habíamos hospedado una dama.
We were having a lady staying at our house back in those days.
Se había separado del esposo.
She had,
esposa quiso ayudarla ahí.
She had recently separated from her husband, and so my wife wanted to help her out, so she brought her to our house.
Era una dama joven, muy bella.
She was a very beautiful young lady.
Y cuando yo llegué,
and when I came back,
la dama abre.
That young lady opened the door.
Y me dice, si hubiera llegado
and she
dos
said,
minutos antes,
oh, Pastor, if you would have come in just 2 minutes earlier,
me habrías encontrado completamente desnudo.
You would have found me completely naked.
No se requiere mucho discernimiento para saber que era una insinuación.
You don't need much discernment to realize what she was trying to do.
Y uno empieza a sentir
and so I started feeling
una sensación extraña.
This awful, strange feeling.
Me sentí confundido, Dios.
I felt very confused, and I was like, Lord, what do I do?
Y lo que hice fue,
and what did I do?
Irme a un cuarto.
I went into a room and prayed.
Señor,
I said, Lord, help me.
Este es un ataque del diablo.
This is an attack from the devil.
Yo no quiero fallar.
I don't want to fail you.
Pero necesito
tu but respuesta. I need your support in this.
Solo no puedo enfrentar
because
esto.
I can't face this on my own.
Y ahí tomé autoridad.
In that moment I took authority.
Y Dios me dio la victoria.
And God gave me victory.
Ah, cuando sentí la victoria.
When I felt that he gave me victory.
El Señor me dijo.
The Lord said to me.
Quiero que observes esto.
I want you to see this.
Y veo en visión tres demonios.
And in a vision he showed me 3 demons.
Y me dice,
and he said to me,
esos 3 demonios te estaban esperando.
Those 3 demons, they were waiting for you.
Si tú hubieses caído con esta
if
joven,
you would have fallen into sin with that young lady,
uno habría sido asignado,
one of those demons would have been assigned
para tus hijas,
to your daughters,
otro para tu esposa,
another one would have been assigned to your wife,
otro para ti,
and the other one was going to be assigned to you.
Okay.
And I was like, whoa.
Recuerden,
remember,
el pecado trae un precio muy alto.
Sin, it comes at a very high price.
Por eso,
and that's why,
no jueguen con el pecado.
Don't play around with sin.
Huid de la tentación.
Run away from temptation. Flee from temptation.
El huir no es cobardía.
So when you flee, you're not a coward.
Jesús sabía que tenía que enfrentarse al adversario.
Jesus knew that he needed to face the enemy.
Y cuando el adversario
and when the enemy,
le ofrece y le dice, convierte estas piedras en pan.
When he offered him and he said, turn these rocks into bread.
Jesús le dice,
Jesus said to him,
no, porque es escrito,
no, for it is written,
no solo de pan,
man shall not live out of bread alone,
palabra,
but out of every word that comes out of the mouth of God.
No fue una batalla fuerte.
It wasn't a strong battle.
Jesús estaba preparado.
Jesus was prepared for that battle.
No fue una guerra.
It wasn't a war.
De aplastarle la cabeza al diablo.
Tread on the head of the devil. I tread on your head.
No.
No.
Simplemente usó la palabra.
He just used the word.
Escrito está.
It is written.
Y dio el verso correcto.
And he spoke the right scripture.
Cuando lo llevó al pináculo del
When he brought him up to the pinnacle of the temple.
El enemigo le dice,
the enemy said, jump.
Haz una obra extraordinaria.
An extraordinary act.
Nadie lo ha hecho.
No one has ever done this.
Imagínese.
Imagine.
Volando.
Flying down.
Desde el pináculo del
templo. From the pinnacle of the temple.
Los ángeles vendrán.
The angels will come.
Te tomarán las manos.
And they will take you in their
hands. No dejarán que tú.
And they will not allow your foot to stumble and fall.
Yo creo que esa tentación.
That temptation.
Fue que se inspiró el de Superman.
That's the temptation that inspired Superman.
¿Y Jesús qué le dijo?
And what did Jesus reply?
No, porque escrito.
No, for it is written.
No tentarás.
You will, shall not tempt the Lord your God.
Y luego,
and then,
se quita su antifaz y se muestra como el diablo.
He removed his mask and showed himself as for what he was, the devil.
Y le dice, tú viniste a recuperar la
and
corona
he said,
de Adán.
You've come to recover the crown that Adam lost in the garden.
Te doy todo.
He said, look, I'll give
esas
you everything, todo. Riches, wealth, and glory. I'll give it all back to
Solo
you.
Pido una cosa.
I just ask for one thing.
Dobla tu rodilla
that
y
you fall on your knees and worship me.
Y Jesús le dijo,
and Jesus replied and said,
Vete de mí, Satanás.
Get away from me, Satan.
Porque escrito está.
For it is written,
Al Señor tu
you
Dios adora.
Will worship the Lord your God
y a él solo serve.
And you will only serve him.
Y el diablo le dejó.
And the devil left him.
Lucas capítulo 4.
Luke chapter 4.
En el verso 14 dice.
In verse 14 says.
Que Jesús.
That Jesus.
Bajó del monte.
He came down from the mountain.
En el poder del Espíritu.
In the power of the Spirit.
Note que lo que da el poder.
Notice that what gives us power.
No es que venga la unción de Dios.
Is not that God's anointing comes upon us.
Sino cuando vence la tentación.
But it's when we overcome temptation. That's when power comes upon us.
Eso es lo que da el poder.
That's what gives us power.
Y por eso Jesús bajó.
And that's why Jesus came down.
En el poder del
in the power of the Spirit.
Y cuando entra a la sinagoga.
And when he walked into the synagogue at Nazareth.
Le alcanzan
they handed him
Isaías.
The scroll of prophet Isaiah.
Y él lo abre en el capítulo 61.
And he opened it in Isaiah chapter 61 and he read it.
¿Y qué fue lo que leyó?
And what did he read?
El Espíritu de Jehová
the Spirit
Señor
of
mí.
The Lord God is upon me.
Porque me ha ungido
for
Jehová.
He has anointed me.
Me ha enviado a predicar buenas
and he has sent me to pobres. Preach good tidings to the poor.
A liberar a los oprimidos.
He has sent me to heal the broken
hearted.
To proclaim
herido.
Liberty to the captives.
Abrir la cárcel.
And the opening of the prison to those who are bound.
A proclamar el año de
to
la
proclaim
buena voluntad.
The acceptable year of the Lord.
Y dijo,
and he said,
hoy,
today,
se ha cumplido.
This scripture
esta escritura
has come to pass
delante de vosotros.
Before you.
¿Sabe de qué estaba hablando?
Do you know what he was talking about?
Semejanza.
He was talking about the likeness of God.
Había adquirido la semejanza de
because
Dios.
He had acquired the likeness of God.
El Espíritu de Dios
the Spirit of God
está sobre mí.
Is upon me.
Vino a conectarse.
So he came to connect.
Y llegó a ser uno con el Padre,
and
con
he
el Espíritu Santo.
Became one with the Holy Spirit.
Y por eso dijo,
and that's why he said,
el Espíritu de Dios
the Spirit of the Lord God
está sobre mí.
Is upon me.
¿Cuál es la lucha del ser humano?
So what is the biggest struggle for humans?
Que tenemos al Espíritu Santo un día,
that we have the Holy Spirit one day
y le damos vacaciones al día
and then we leave him on vacation for a day.
Él tiene que estar todo
no, he doesn't want vacation. He wants to be with you
él
all the
tiene
time.
Que tomar el control.
He wants to have control of your
él
life.
Adquirió la semejanza,
but Jesus acquired the likeness of God when he overcame temptation.
Dale un aplauso.
Come on, give Jesus a great hand of praise.
Ahora,
now,
queremos establecer el reino de Dios.
We want to establish the kingdom of God.
Jesús lo dijo.
Jesus said it.
¿Cómo deberíamos orar?
He told us how we needed to pray.
Venga tu reino.
He said, "Your kingdom come."
El reino de Dios.
The kingdom of God.
Viene a través del Espíritu Santo.
It comes through the Holy Spirit.
Recordemos.
Now, let's remember.
Que en Marcos capítulo 1, verso 15.
Mark chapter 1 and verse 15.
El Señor Jesucristo dijo,
Jesus said,
el tiempo se ha cumplido.
He said, the time has been fulfilled.
Y el reino de Dios se ha acercado.
And the kingdom of God is at hand.
Arrepentíos y creed.
Repent and believe in the gospel.
Cuando es el tiempo de Dios,
when it's God's timing,
el Espíritu de Dios,
the Spirit of God,
es el que tiene que tomar el control
is
de
the one that has to take control of our lives.
Ahora, quiero hacerles una pregunta.
Now, let me ask you a question.
¿Qué controla su vida?
What controls your life?
Sus pensamientos.
Is it your thoughts?
Mente.
Is it, that's your mind?
Sus emociones.
Your emotions?
Emociones.
Yeah, your emotions.
O voluntad.
Or is it your will?
Jesús.
Jesus.
Nunca
he siguió. Never, he was never moved.
Por mente.
By his mind.
Emociones.
He was never moved by his emotions or by his will.
Él siguió.
He was moved
por la palabra.
By the word of God.
El hacer tu voluntad.
Doing your will.
Oh Padre.
Oh Father.
Me ha agradado.
Is what pleases me.
Y lo más difícil para el ser humano.
And the most difficult part for human beings.
Es obedecer lo que Dios dice.
Be obedient to what God says in his word.
A veces
a lot of times,
nos manda a hacer cosas.
God has us do things.
Que nos parecen sencillas.
That seem, you know, simple for us.
Pero hay otras.
But then there are other times.
Donde las vemos muy difíciles.
When he asks us to do things that seem very difficult to
pero
us.
Pero Dios sabe por qué nos pide.
But God knows why he's asking us to do those
y
things.
Hagamos la voluntad de él.
So that we could do his will.
Jesús rindió la totalidad.
Jesus fully surrendered his life.
A la voluntad del Padre.
To the will of the Father.
Y por eso fue respaldado.
And that's why he was so used by the Father.
En verdad.
So, I want to know.
¿Usted siente que obedece a Dios?
Do you really feel that you are obedient to God?
¿Usted siente?
Do you really feel
que ha tenido autoridad sobre la tentación?
That you have authority over temptation?
¿O es consciente?
Or are you aware
de que cae y cae?
That you stumble and fall and fall and stumble and fall.
Y sigue cayendo.
But you continue
y no sabe
stumbling
qué hacer
and falling and you don't know what to do.
Para que esto cambie.
For that to change.
Le tengo una buena noticia.
Well, I have very good news for you today.
Si he entendido esta palabra,
if you have understood this word that I have spoken,
hoy todo puede cambiar.
Today, everything could change in your life.
Y me gustaría saber cuántas personas
and I'd like to know how many of you know
que necesitan
that you need
rendir la totalidad de sus vidas
to fully surrender your lives to God.
Porque han batallado con algo
because you've been battling with something
que no han podido vencer.
That you've not been able to overcome.
Levante las manos.
If that's you, raise your hand wherever you are.
Voy a pedirles que vengan acá.
And I'm going to ask you to come to the altar.
Impactó mucho
I was so impressed
la oración de David.
By the prayer that David prayed.
David, a pesar de que
David,
era ese hombre conforme al corazón de
even
Dios,
even though he was a man after the heart of God,
y tuvo una página oscura en su vida.
Yet he had a very dark page in his story.
Cuando falló con Betsabé,
when he
Urias,
fell into sin with Bathsheba, with Uriah's wife.
Cuando fue desenmascarado por el profeta Natán,
when everything came out to the open by Prophet Nathan.
El arrepentimiento de David fue genuino.
David's repentance was genuine repentance.
No justificó su pecado.
He didn't even try to justify his
sin. No lo encubrió.
He didn't cover up his sin.
No lo disimuló.
He didn't try to act as if it wasn't that bad.
Él rasgó su corazón.
But he just opened his heart.
Y lo derramó en oración.
And he poured his heart out to the Father.
Y por eso compuso el Salmo 51.
And that's why he wrote Psalm 51.
que es la expresión de un arrepentimiento como muy pocos textos hay en la Biblia.
It is the highest expression of repentance like very few scriptures in the Bible.
Pero cuando llega al verso 7,
but when he comes to verse 7,
él le dice,
he said,
purifícame con hisopo,
purge me with hyssop,
y seré limpio,
and I shall be clean,
lávame,
wash me,
y seré más blanco,
and I shall be whiter than snow.
Note que
notice
David,
that David
apeló a lo más poderoso,
he had to appeal to the most powerful thing
del Antiguo Testamento,
that we find in the Old Testament.
Lo más poderoso fue la Pascua.
Because the most powerful thing about the Old Testament was Passover.
Fue cuando Moisés,
the moment in which Moses,
orientó a todos los padres de familia,
led the father of every household,
que deberían sacrificar un cordero,
to go and sacrifice a lamb,
recoger la sangre del cordero en un recipiente,
were to gather the blood of the lamb in a recipient,
y con un recipiente, y con ramas de hisopo,
in a basin, and then they were to take hyssop branches,
debería mojarlas,
and they were to dip the hyssop
en la sangre,
in the blood,
y aplicarla,
and then use the hyssop
en los dos postes,
to apply the blood on the two doorposts,
y en el dintel,
and on the lintel of their doors,
para proteger de la, para
to
la protección de la familia,
protect their families from death.
David apeló,
David,
al hisopo,
he appealed to that same thing, that hyssop,
ramas que se dan abundantemente en el Medio Oriente,
hyssop branches that are very abundant in the Middle East, in Israel.
Fue las que Dios usó.
It's what God used.
¿Por qué hisopo?
Why hyssop branches?
Porque el hisopo nos habla de confesión.
Because hyssop refers to a confession that we need to make.
Esa acción de mojar en la
sangre. That action of dipping the hyssop in the blood,
y aplicar en la puerta,
and then putting it on the doorposts,
implica la confesión.
It represented a confession.
Es cuando nosotros confesamos.
It's when we confess
lo que la sangre de Jesús,
what the blood of Jesus,
ha hecho por nosotros,
has done for us.
Hoy,
today,
prácticamente estamos en las mismas condiciones.
We are practically in the same condition today.
Purifícame con hisopo,
purge me with hyssop,
y seré limpio,
and I shall be made clean.
Lávame,
wash me,
y seré más blanco que la nieve,
and I will be whiter than snow.
Pero ¿cuál es ese hisopo?
But what is that hyssop?
La sangre.
It's the blood.
No de cualquier cordero.
And it's not the blood of just anything.
Del cordero de Dios.
But it's the blood of the Lamb of God.
Esa sangre nos dice.
And that blood tells us.
El precio de tu pecado,
that the price of your sin,
ya fue pagado,
has already been paid for.
No tienes que ser esclavo de esto.
So you don't have to be a slave of whatever it is anymore.
La muerte de Jesús,
Jesus' death,
fue,
was
su misma muerte,
your death.
Jesús te amó tanto,
Jesus loved you so much, he loved you so much,
que él lo quiso,
that he didn't want
que tú recibieras el castigo.
He didn't want you to receive the punishment.
Él pagó el castigo.
He paid for your punishment.
Ya él lo pagó.
He's already paid for it.
No tienes por qué pagar.
You don't have to pay for it.
No tienes por qué cargar una culpa.
You don't have to carry that guilt around.
No tienes por qué llevar una maldición.
You don't have to carry a curse around anymore.
Él lo hizo todo.
He did it all for you.
Pablo lo entendió.
Paul understood it very clearly.
Y él mismo dijo,
and he himself said,
con Cristo estoy juntamente,
he said, I am crucified along with Christ.
Ya no vivo yo.
And I no longer live.
Ahora vive
but now it is Christ living in me.
Y lo que vivo en la carne,
and what I live in the flesh,
lo vivo en la fe,
I live in the faith of the Son of God,
el cual me amó,
who loved me
and
gave himself for me.
La muerte de Jesús,
Jesus' death,
fue mi muerte,
was my death.
Usted puede mirar la cruz.
So you could come to the cross.
Quedó en un presente continuo.
It is in a continuous present.
Jesucristo es el mismo de ayer, de hoy y de siempre.
The same yesterday, today, and forever.
La obra de la cruz está viva
ahora.
The
work of the cross is still alive today. He is justifying you today. And we're going to see him. And we're going to see the old man hanging on the cross.
Y vamos a recibir.
And we're going to receive
al hombre nuevo.
The new man.
A Jesús.
Jesus.
Es él, su espíritu de santidad,
and his spirit of holiness,
viviendo en nosotros,
living inside every one of us.
Ya no vivo yo.
I no longer live.
Ahora vive Cristo.
But now it is Christ living in me.
Y lo que vivo en este cuerpo,
and what I live in this human body,
lo vivo en la fe.
I live in the faith
del Hijo de
Dios, of the Son of God,
el que se entregó a sí mismo por
mí, who loved me and gave himself for me.
O a su mano derecha en el corazón.
Place your right hand over your heart.
Yo solamente les voy a guiar.
And I'm just going to guide you in this prayer.
Señor Jesús.
Lord Jesus.
Hoy reconozco.
Today I recognize.
Que soy pecado.
That I am a sinner.
He hecho lo malo.
I have done wrong before you.
Delante de tus ojos.
Before your eyes.
Perdóname.
Forgive me.
Yo me arrepiento.
Lord, I repent.
Por todos mis pecados.
For all my sins.
Por todas mis maldades.
I repent of all the bad things I've done.
Por todo lo malo que he hecho.
I repent of all the evil that I've done.
Y acepto. Y acepto.
And I accept.
Que tu muerte en la cruz.
That your death on the cross.
Fue mi muerte al pecado.
Was my death to sin.
Pagaste el precio.
You paid the price.
De todas mis maldades.
For all evil in me.
Acepto.
And Lord, I accept.
Que estoy crucificado.
That I am crucified.
Juntamente contigo.
Along with you.
En la cruz del Calvario.
On the cross of Calvary.
Pero también acepto.
And I also accept.
Que mi cuerpo.
That my body.
Es tu templo.
Is your body.
Ven y mora en él.
Come and dwell in my body.
Jesús.
Lord Jesus.
Vive la vida cristiana a través de mí.
Come and live Christian life through me.
Te lo pido, Señor.
Lord, I pray that you do this.
A la gloria de tu nombre.
For the glory of your name.
Ahora por un momento.
And now for a brief moment.
Mientras visualizas la cruz.
As you visualize the cross.
Que está encima suyo.
It's right above you.
Tú vas a hacer algo.
You're gonna do something.
Vas a dar un grito como de guerra.
You're gonna shout in a moment, a shout like a shout of
cuando
war.
Cuando yo termine de contar.
When I count to three.
Y en ese grito de guerra.
And in that shout of war.
Vas a sentir.
You're gonna feel.
Que esa vieja naturaleza.
That old nature.
Sale de su vida.
Comes out of your life.
Y queda crucificada.
And it is crucified.
En la cruz.
On the cross.
Da un grito bien prolongado.
So you're going to shout a long and loud shout.
Hasta que sienta.
Until you feel.
Que ya esa naturaleza quedó en
la cruz. That nature is now on the cross.
Uno.
One.
Dos.
Two.
Tres.
And three.
Ese grito como ensayo estuvo bien.
That was a very nice rehearsal.
Pero no fue ese grito donde yo sintiera que todos los demonios salieran.
But it wasn't the kind of shout where your every demon comes out.
Recuerde, estás mandando
Remember,
los demonios a la cruz.
You are sending those demons to the cross.
Solo debe quedar.
And not one should remain.
Gritarlo con toda su.
So you're going to shout with all the strength within you.
De nuevo voy a contar.
Once again, I'm going to count to three, and you're going to shout.
One,
two, three!
Su mano en la cabeza.
Now place your hand over your head.
Y dile, Padre,
and say, Father,
lléname,
fill me
del Espíritu Santo,
with the Holy Spirit.
Toma el control
Take
total
control,
de mi vida.
Absolute control of my life.
Controla mi mente.
Control my mind.
Mi vista.
My sight.
Mi lengua.
My mind.
Mis emociones.
My emotions.
Mi voluntad.
My will.
Todo lo que yo soy.
Everything that I am.
Toma el control.
Come and take control now, Lord.
Para poderte adorar.
So that I could worship you.
En espíritu y en verdad.
In spirit and in truth.
Gracias, Señor.
Thank you, Lord.
Por llenarme de tu espíritu.
For filling me with your spirit.
Y llenarme de tu amor.
And for filling me with your love.
Te amo, Jesús.
I love you, Jesus.
Te amo, Jesús.
I love you, Jesus.
Te amo, Jesús. Ahora vas a cruzar los brazos así.
And now cross your arms like this.
Y vas a sentir.
And you're gonna feel.
Que el Espíritu Santo viene y te abraza.
That the Holy Spirit is embracing you.
Recibe el amor de Dios.
So receive the love of God.
Recibe el amor del Padre.
Receive the love of the Father.
Vas a sentir que es tu propio papá.
And you're going to feel that it's your Father embracing you.
El Padre celestial abrazando.
Our heavenly Father embracing every one of us.
Dándole la bienvenida.
Welcome him.
Así como cuando el padre recibió al hijo pródigo.
Just like when the father received the prodigal son.
El padre te está abrazando.
The father is embracing you the same way today.
Se está alegrando mucho contigo.
He is rejoicing with you.
Y en ese abrazo está cambiando tus vestiduras.
And through that embrace he is changing your garments.
Toda tu naturaleza.
Everything about your nature is being changed.
Y él te da la confianza.
And he gives you the confidence.
A partir de ahora yo estaré contigo.
From this moment forward I will be with you.
Yo te voy a ayudar en cada momento.
I'm going to help you in every step of the way.
No temas.
So fear not.
Yo voy a ser tu fuerza.
For I will be your strength.
Tu escudo. Tu escudo.
I will be your shield.
Tu protector.
I will be your protection.
Yo voy a estar contigo.
I will be with you.
Y te voy a bendecir.
And I will bless you.
Dale un aplauso.
Come on, give Jesus the best hand of praise you can.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.